Good evening, my vacuum cleaner chums. How are you today? Tonight, this isn't an after. As much as I have polished this Hoover Sensotronic system to up and put it back together, but we are still repairing it. Let me show you what I hope to be showing you in this video. Now, as you can see, the back full light is on permanently. And if you look here, the economy light doesn't work either. Now, this is because I broke one bit and the other bit was already broken. Ignore that button, I do have that. I'd lost it when I put it back together. I have found it again. That needs to go back on. But there's two things to fix here. And hopefully, from what the postman bought today, if I can make my phone stand up, we shall fix it. Because here, in this envelope, I have... Where are they? Aha, two things. These. I only need one, but I can only buy five. These are called magnetic switches. And this is what causes the bag full light to indicate. There's a magnet in the airflow. And the power of magic, it moves and closes these contacts to put the bag full light on. I broke it because they're made of glass. Which is why it is on, because it is shorted, basically. So we need to fit one of those. Now, the economy light and the bag full light are run by these. Which aren't LEDs. I thought they were or could be replaced by LEDs. They are glow light indicators. And I'm hoping that the economy switch one has blown, because if not, I need to look at the resistors, and I'm not very good at looking at resistors. So, they were very cheap. I thought I'd try it. They are different to the ones fitted, which I will show you when we get to that stage, but I'm hoping that it's just 30 years of miniaturisation, as opposed to them being very different indeed. So I have my soldering iron out. I won't plug it in yet, because obviously we need to disassemble this to get to the bits. So we will take off the very shiny bag cover and the very clean tool tray and the bag that actually has dirt in it that I really must replace. Actually, there is one more thing we need to fix. I'll show you that later though, because I've left those parts in the car. So what I need to do is find my teeny tiny, you can't even see that, this very, there we go, the small Torx driver to remove these two screws here. How are you all doing? Are you all okay? Hang on, I'm missing a trick here. Because it's only went back together a few days ago, I've still got the screw card. So rather than lobbing all these screws into different random piles, ooh, hello, bye bye. I dropped you, I'm very sorry. There we go. I can put all the screws where they should go and hopefully not lose them. There we go, there's those two, etc. Now this just lifts off, and as you can see, this was a right pain to work out. All of these wires are what links the two together. So for the minute, we can just unplug them, because the two repairs we are doing are different parts of the board. We need that later, but not right now. The bit that we need to replace, I haven't put my light on because I'm trying to save your battery a bit, because this could be a long boring one. Those blue wires there are what links it to the magnetic switch. Put it down now. So we need to take the motor out, and I'm hoping we can get away with just that, because otherwise the core rewind needs to come out. And that was a right pain in the bum. In fact, let's just do the cord up so it's out of the way. There we go. So to get the motor out, we need to take off, sort of push all the wiring out of the way and tuck it down there, like so. Then There's two live cables we need to move. One is on this sort of weird connector here, which just pulls apart. And the other, I haven't. I thought I cable tied that together, but I haven't. Where is it? Yeah, I'm going to have to snip a cable tie here. Obviously, when I put it back together, I replaced the original factory cable tie. Which was a silly thing to do because I need to get rid of it. Oh, now his Stanley knife won't open. It's jammed. Hang on. Bear with me. Here are some snips. There we go. So, I'm hoping I can snip the tie without snipping the loom, because that would be very sad. There we go. Because, and I need to find it, one of the motor wires, this is a four-way block here on a Sensotronic System 2. And I can't remember which one goes which. But one of these, I think it's that one, but I can't actually remember. They all join up together. That's to the suppressor. I did think about taking it out, but I would need to replace that wire. We might do it actually, because we've got the soldering iron out. We can just solder it together. We'll see how we do for time. It is 20 to 9 at the minute. My girlfriend is out being pampered. So I've grabbed the opportunity doing this for video, because I haven't done a video in a while. I must remember to not move that so you can't see it. So the motor is held down with four screws, which I shall put in the screw card where they were just a few days ago. Oh, I've dropped one. Here we go, magnetic screwdrivers, best in the world. Not all of mine are magnetized. Have any of you not ever bought those screw magnetizer things? And do they work? Because some of my screwdrivers are magnetic, some aren't, and they're very handy when they are. And I'm sure you must be able to magnetize them. I mean, I don't last for long, but even if I had to do it every so often, that would be fine. And then hopefully, although there's one more cable that we have to remove, which is a pain, this yellow link wire, I think it must be an earth, screws to there. And the way I did it is to pop the screwdriver all the way into there, and it's a bit fiddly and it's not particularly not clever, what's the word, neat, that's the one, but you can undo it and you can get it out, but getting it back in is a bit of a pain because you can't get the screw. You can, I've got it out, we'll put that there. There we go. So, oh, it was that brown wire I said it was. And the motor can come out. And, right, now we can see a bit better. And hopefully I won't have to take the firewall out. So, we have lots of wires here. That will be for the thermal cutout. There is a brown and blue. They go all the way down to the front of the machine to the powerhead connector there. Well, what we're interested in is this, and if I there you go, look, that's part of it already. That sellotape, it's not the original, but that did come from the factory. I'm going to be a bit careful now not to drop little bits of glass everywhere. So here is the article. Now I got this out fine, but getting it back in, I broke it because it has to slip behind. You won't see it, the little plastic channel. It has to push in, and I cracked it. There's a bit of glass that once contained it. And as you can see, these two little terminals here, you can't see very well now, but they push together to create a switch. Now, I'm hoping that I bought the right part, because these are very much smaller, but I'm just hoping it's miniaturization. They're 10 watts. And I don't think there was any markings on the one that there's no markings, so this, if it doesn't work, I might have to buy some bigger ones. Obviously I have to strip the thing down again, that'll be fun. I don't really want to take it out, because then the bag full light will never work, and I do want to sell this. So there we go. I don't know how well you'll be able to see this on my phone, but as you can see, there's two metal contacts. I'm going to have a look at it closer just to check. Yeah, two little metal contacts
that will be magnetised. And hopefully, when they're magnetised, I can't actually see if there's a gap. There isn't. There is. I think it's ever so small. I'm doubting I've got the right parts now. All crumbs. I don't think that's right, you know. I can't see a gap. Maybe it's just terribly small. There's only going to be one way to find out, isn't there? And that's for me to plug in the soldering iron, which hasn't exploded, which is a good sign. Now, I'll pop that there. I need to cut and strip these. It's broken anyway. All I can do is try, and they were very cheap, so if it doesn't work, I'll just have to buy some more. Only a couple of pounds for five. I'm sure the listing said open. I can't check now because I'm filming on my phone. But and that's where I'd have to look at eBay. Where are my wire cutters? These will do. These aren't the nicer ones, but they will do for now. That's dropped in there somewhere. I'll tip that out of it. There we go. Now, I'll just find some sellotape to insulate the terminals. Only joking, I've got some heat shrink. I'll pop those over now because I've done that before. I've forgotten. Got it all nicely done and oh, I can't actually terminate. I can't do the doodah. So we'll pop that on there. We'll use big bits because sod it. I might cut this bit down actually. Just because otherwise there's not going to be enough space. There we go. So we have heat shrink ready. Oh god, you can't even see. There we go. Because I can't show you this bit well because I'm not that good at soldering, so this is going to be a bit tricky for me, let alone anybody else. I don't know if any of you guys follow, there's a guy called Big Clive, bigclive.com. He's an awesome solderer. If you ever watch any of his videos, blimey, he does it with his eyes closed. There's Big Clive. Very envious of Big Clive's soldering skills I am. Need to wait for my iron to warm up a little bit. I do. You still there? Are we hot yet? Aha! So, we shall tin the wires, which apparently helps. I don't know if I can do it so you can see it. I'm very sorry if you can't see it. But I haven't really got any other way of showing it. That one's done. And if I just pull this one across so I don't melt anything, because that'll be fun, wouldn't it? I go to all the effort fixing this and bugger up the plastic. Won't be very happy with that. No! No, naughty. Don't do that. Come to where I am holding you. There we go. Now, I've got to try and one-handedly, I don't see if I can do it like Big Clive, because he holds a bit of solder in one hand, and the bit he's actually soldering in the other. And God knows how, but he manages to make them stick. Magic. Right, that bit's stuck. But not terribly well, I don't think. Oh, no, I just made it come off again. Silly boy. I do recommend learning to solder. Possibly better than I'm doing here. I can't solder well, but I can solder well enough. And all my solder's home tool, I just need to do it more. I actually learned to solder. Do you remember that Roomba that you would have seen on my channel a long, long while ago? Well, I've still got that, and I've still got to fix it. And that's mainly why I started to try and learn to solder. Because I've got to try and take the little chips off of the motherboard and put the new chips on, which is going to be a riot. Especially with my soldering skills as rubbish as they are. So that's mainly why I haven't done it yet. Because it involves soldering stuff that I'm not very good at. I might cheat here. Oh, no, that didn't work. I was going to try and push the end of this into the insulation of the cable. I wonder if I pull the heat shrink up to there. I'll show you what I'm doing in a minute. Hang on, let me see. Hey. There we go. So that side is done badly. I'm sure some of you agree. And that side is now holding itself. So in theory, I can just, if you can even see, touch the soldering iron to melt the solder. There you go. Now that has taken it. Just so, what I need to do now is pop you back up here. I'll have to be up one-handed, try not to drop the soldering iron on the carpet. Oh, I've nearly soldered through. Oh, I caught that on the wire then. That was silly. Oh, it soldered all cut out. And just fill it up, get it all done. I don't know if I want to put any more on that one in case it all comes off again. Ah, like that. Why do I touch stuff? Just leave it. There we go. Right. I'll try and get the flipping heat shrink over it now. Right, we'll unplug the soldering iron. God, I hope I bought the right bit so that we've got to do all this again. I won't film it happening again if it happens. Right, now I need to snip off this little bit here. Like so, get rid of that and hope that the heat shrink now fits over these joints. I've melted that a bit. I don't think this is going to work, everybody. Do I even upload the video? My shameful attempt at fixing this Sensotronic, although we can get the theory at least. You know, I don't even need to shrink this heat shrink down, it's just the right size as it is. Might do a little bit, but I have melted. This isn't glass, this one, it's plastic. I have melted it ever so slightly. The actual housing. Okay, I don't know if you can see. See that blob there, that is melted. I'm an idiot, but unfortunately, I can't actually now check this without us putting it back together. Basically. So now I need to try and get all the wire back in its little channel. This was a lot easier when it was on my knee, I must admit. It's got to sit in the right place to meet up with the magnet that's underneath the pre-motor filter. Oh, this is tricky. Oh, have I broken that again? Oh no, look, I have broken it. Oh, I have snapped it again. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stop filming now. You get the idea. I have just broken it again. I need to concentrate a bit because this is more difficult than it looks. So I'm going to stop, do it, cut this back together. There's going to be another 20 minutes of me swearing. So see you in a minute. Right.
I think it is done. It didn't break. It's not as good as it could be because it doesn't all sit in the channel properly, but obviously that's how I broke the first one, trying to get it to sit in the channel, and you can't see it when it's all back together. So I'll be honest, it's sitting in the right part of the notch to line up with the magnet that sits behind there. It didn't break. I even got the multimeter out and tested, and there wasn't continuity, so I think it is the right one. Time will tell if it's man enough. All that sellotape, there was sellotape on there originally. Obviously it was genuine Hoover sellotape, not whatever I stole from the stationery cupboard at work sellotape. Excuse me, whenever I tell a naughty story I cough. But it'll do. Once the motor's there, you won't see it. So I'm not going to film the motor going back in, but I'm going to again stock. I'm having to edit this video together. You are being spoilt today, because I'm not going to film myself putting it all back together. You get the idea. We shall see what it's like when it's tested. So for you it'll be 3 seconds, for me it'll be half a can of adult juice and some time reassembling. So we are reassembled. I didn't have to drink that much beer. It was okay. So we're plugged in. Does it work? Ooh, the lights off. Success! Fixed for £2.20 worth of parts. I still have 3 left. So if anybody needs one of these and doesn't want to buy 5, although I'll be honest, it probably cost you the same to buy 5 as it would cost me to post you one even for 3. So! Fix number one done. I don't know if you noticed the motor there. Don't know if you noticed the motor there. It was a little bit sparky, wasn't it? I'm not sure if I should be worried about that really, because he's probably always done it. So, we won't worry about that for now. Right, I've unplugged it, because while we're here, we may as well do bodge number 2, which is to remove this suppressor. Obviously, suppressors, and this is a big argument actually in the vacuum cleaning community. As people say, oh, you should leave them in, oh, they were fitted there, they should be fitted. Well, I don't quite fall into that camp, I'm afraid, because this isn't the 1970s anymore. These things could explode. I mean, they won't cause any damage, but they'll make you need a fresh pair of underpants. If you collect old valve TVs, then yeah, you probably do need them. But I'll be honest, we've got an LCD TV there that I picked up off the side of the road a few years ago. We've got a digital skybox, we've got flipping digital bloody light bulbs. I've used cleaners without suppressors for years and it's been alright. I have refitted some of them. On my Dolphins I bought some for Maplin's, just for the crack really, just to see what it was like, and it didn't really improve my life any. So, and obviously if you've watched any of Ibaziac's videos, I mean, he's a massive wimp when it comes to suppressors. Oh, I've done it again. I'm sorry. That'll wake you up, wouldn't it, if you're watching that in bed? He has had a fair few explode on him. Watch his lecture notes video. I gave him a few hints on Facebook as to just get rid of the bloody thing, because it doesn't affect the running at all. They are a throwback to an analog age, which we just don't live in anymore. But so if you do happen to collect old TVs, ignore that advice, because yeah, it is rubbish advice if you do collect old televisions and radios. See if I can put you in a better position, because what I'm just going to do is basically just solder these black wires together. Get a bit of heat shrink. We might even take the... I'll leave the bracket on for originality. You know, these weirdo vacuum collectors, they like their originality, don't they? How are we doing for time? We're still recording. I was recording something the other day and it flipping stopped recording and I couldn't have time to redo it. It was only a DC-19. Wasn't anything interesting. You'll see it again because I haven't actually sold it. I lent it out to somebody and I just feel myself bodging it back together because it's not worth selling. Really? I use it as a low vac. I just feel myself changing the filter. It's even a storm Doris actually. That's why it stopped filming. I dropped my phone again as I seem to often do. Right. Now, let's very badly try and get these together. I can't use my little helpy handy thing. See this is what came in my soldering kit. Oh, pardon me. And it can be quite handy. But only if you can get it in the right position to start with, and I don't think I can. Helps people like me what can't solder very well. I actually might be able to. Hello, 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 hello. Oh, look at that. You can look. Bit of perseverance. Look, that holds the wires in exactly the right spot. And I've already tinned them with solder. It won't focus on them now because it's got too much going on. But there you go. They're now stuck together. Using metal. Not quite the Mr. Rusty Skull way of sticking metal together. Should go and pay him a visit really, my car needs rear arches. The day it fails the MOT, Rusty, I'll come and find you. There we go. Unplugged, but we're not done with the soldering iron of fun yet. Get rid of that. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing really. There we go. What I am doing for the people of you who are going, what the fuck are you doing? I can't see anything. It's just heat shrinking the connection for safety. Safety first, children. There we go. Do I have a lighter? Yes. Does it work? No. Yeah, whoa, hello. Woohoo! That'll do. Yeah, done. That'll do. It's not going to move anyway, so just really need that. And there we go. So we best check it now works. It should do. Let's just see if I'm knackered it and need to put that suppressor back. Diddly diddly do. Diddly diddly do. It'd be funny, wouldn't it, if it now explodes as it did before. Bang! Ooh. We have knackered it. Hello, hello, hello. Ooh. That's a turn up for the books. Right. Well, since we took the suppressor out, it now doesn't work, and the lights flickered when I turned it on. I'm going to have to stop again and work out what I've done wrong this time. Well, this is turning into a fun video, isn't it? Top tip for Tuesday. Don't believe anything you hear off the internet. Because I don't think that was a suppressor. I think it was something else. Because when I turned it on after removing it, it didn't blow the fuse in the plug. It blew the fuse in this extension. Yes. And because I cut it off so flipping close, it only just about went on, but it's on. And it runs. And we shall say no more about it. We shall never speak of this again. Did not happen. Oi, our little secret. So, eventually, the whole thing works. We have fixed one issue. So, we don't need that part anymore. What we need to do is get in here. We need to get in here. and have a look at the it's not an LED, I keep calling it an LED. It's not an LED. It is apparently the precursor to the LED. A neon lamp indicator. Now, don't worry that I don't know how to put those together, because I shall just look at the picture that I took the first time.
Nah.
In fact, before I put this back together, I'll put that flipping missing button in as well. So, these come out. There is a bit of damage to this machine. It came from, I can't actually remember his name, but if I say Vacuum Cleaner Destroyer and his mother, a few of you will know what I mean. And I had to fix it the day it came, because the buttons weren't together properly. And unfortunately, where is it? Yeah, there. That's broken. So my aim is to glue this together once it is fully working and never has to come apart again. So if I lift up this, I'm hoping I haven't got to take the entire lube out. I think I might have to. I don't know, if I cut this cable tight here. I only put it in 2 days ago, idiot. We don't need much, we just need, that, if I can push that through. This is the one that doesn't work. Actually, that looks quite a bit different, doesn't it? Ooh, we're going to try it anyway, because we're here. And there's nothing else we can do. So, I'm going to leave enough. If it all goes wrong, I can put that back on and we can pretend this never happened. Plug the IMD solder in. Now this I am unsure about. I was fairly confident in the end that the other bits would work. This I don't know. It doesn't matter what it looks like, because obviously it's all hidden behind all the cover. What matters is that it works, really. As long as it works, I'm not that fast. It just has to work, really. Let's see. That's all we can do. Because this is all protected with circuit boards. It's behind the cord rewind. Oh, this soldering iron's filthy. If you clean that up. This sponge is getting a bit knackered. Ah, there's the solder. Ooh. Can't move this phone, you can hear me breathing like a paedophile. As I bent over slightly triple. I'm too big of a fat to be bending over slightly triple. Let me tell you that now. Where did I put the flipping thing? There it is. Oh, oh, we forgot the heat shrink. Nearly. Let's never forget the heat shrink, people. Never forget. So it's always easier to do it now, just before you do it, than just after you've done it. Because you've obviously got to take it all apart. Oh, that's warm. Right, here we go. I'm not going to cut these tails down, because there's plenty of room under here. Dry, not dry, cool. Cool down. And hold this with a holdy thing. It is handy. Can be awkward, but it is handy. Is that it? That's it. That's it. I think. Possibly. Oh god, we gotta plug it in now. No. Alright, I'm going to have to pause again just to get all this back together. If I go fully back together, just enough to turn it on with it being electrically safe. So I find out these are wrong as well. I'm not going to do the heat shrink up, because if it is, then I'm going to have to flip it undo it all again. So bear with me, another cut, sorry. Well, it's soldered in, but unfortunately, it's not fixed it. If you watch, you'll see that the bag full light flicks on. I reckon this one must do it as well. So that's a no. It might mean that this actually works fine. I don't think it is this that's the problem. I think, and this isn't going to happen in this video, I'm afraid. I need to do some reading now, because I need to get to the circuit board, and the circuit board sits in there, which means that the cord rewind has to come out and be unwired. This firewall has to come out. So that's not going to happen tonight, I'm afraid. Bum. That's a shame, we were doing so well. But we fixed some stuff. Let's not despair. We've done a fair bit, we fixed that at least. Because in a way, this is back to how it was when I had it. That doesn't work, but it didn't work when I had it. So, in a way, you can say I'm back to square one. With a lovely, shiny Sensotronic. So thank you very much for watching. If you have any idea as to what I should look for, what resistor, what capacitor, what the hell anything is that makes that one not work, please do get in touch, because where are we? There's two red wires. What's the trace? It goes into there, and then out on these browns. One brown goes from somewhere, and the other one goes from this main block, so it will be getting power, obviously, because the economy setting works. Yeah, one red wire goes straight to the switch. Check it's unplugged. I wonder if it's just... Well, it can't be the switch, because the actual setting itself works. It's just a light that doesn't. So, I'm a little bit stumped, I must admit, but I can't look at it tonight. I go to bed, I'm tired, I've been at work. I reckon this neutral actually has nothing to do with it. I don't know, I'm getting more confused just by looking at it. So I have to have a think and see, because yeah, those two, oh, there you go. One of those two goes to the bag light, one goes to here. So it will be getting power because the bag light works. So it's whatever. It's right. I reckon it's that green wire. That green wire must be the data, shall we call it. So a job for another night, I'm afraid. I shall update you how it goes, but I'm going to pack up all this before anybody comes home, get this back together so it doesn't get any more damaged, and we shall revisit it soon. So thank you very much for watching. Sorry we've not been 100% successful. If you have any ideas, please comment, and I shall see you soon. Goodbye.